Whatever your hopes and dreams may be, you will arise from much more comfortable and much more confident than before. It will all seem effortless to you. Now prepare yourself. Arrange your clothes. Arrange your blanket. Put away all other devices so that we will have no disturbances. Let's begin by taking a deep breath together, inhaling through the nose, holding that breath and spreading it throughout your whole body, from the top of your head to the tips of your toes. And only when you've spread the oxygen in your body can you then exhale through the mouth. Again, inhale deeply, 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 relaxing your facial muscles, relaxing your shoulders, spreading the oxygen to all the cells of your body, and exhaling through the mouth with double the time, so that really you empty out any stress. Once again, a deep, deep inhalation, relaxing your jaw in particular by dropping your mouth open, spreading the oxygen throughout your whole body, relaxing your shoulders. And again, exhaling, double the time so that you feel deeply, deeply relaxed. Simply observe your abdomen, your stomach area. Observe how it inflates like a balloon every time you're inhaling, and how it deflates every time you exhale. Allow yourself to breathe naturally, relaxing and being comfortable with every breath you take. That's right, inhaling and exhaling. Your shoulders are relaxing. Your whole right arm is relaxing. Your whole left arm is relaxing. The abdomen area is relaxing. Your genital area is relaxing. Your whole left leg is relaxing. Your whole right leg is relaxing. You feel yourself sinking deeper and deeper in the chair. You find yourself alone, walking along the shore, and listen to the sound of the seagulls. Oh, look, the dolphins come to greet you. You smell the salty sea breeze, and you feel at peace as the sun warms your face. Now you see the island in the near distance. It was always there, but you hadn't noticed it. It's a lush green island, and you're curious, so you begin to swim towards it. The waters beneath are crystal clear, so you feel safe and comfortable as you swim towards the beautiful island. First, your ankles are wet, then your knees, then your waist. As you progress deeper and deeper into the water, you dip your head in. Now you are swimming around a bit, feeling how relaxed it is to be simply floating and flowing in the water. Finally, you have reached the shore on the beach. There is a white linen toga with your name embroidered in gold. You understand that someone has left it there for you, so you put it on. There is also a golden medallion there. And you wear it. And a small sculpture. Once you are dressed, the sculpture transforms into a beautiful woman. You recognize her like a long-lost friend. You are so happy to see her. Is swelling with happiness. Welcome to Eudaimonia, she says, a place of wisdom, wellness, and wonder. Now you are gazing into each other's eyes. She's turning towards the trees now and makes a sign for you to follow her. First, you pass the palm trees. Then the olive trees. Then the cypress trees. And the orange trees. Now you pass the majestic waterfalls. The woman takes you up to the top of the hill to an ancient Grecian temple. She takes you through various corridors to the secret entrance. It is a labyrinth, but she is guiding you. There is a guardian next to the door and asks you to say the secret password. For a moment you hesitate, and then someone whispers it in your ear 3 times. Repeat this word to the guard, and the guard opens the door now saying, "Welcome, lover of wisdom. You have arrived to the place of transformation." You see a chrysalis transforming into a butterfly. Now is the time to reflect on today's philosophy message. We focus on the teachings of the great philosophers. Bad things happen all the time. Things that change our plans. You should be prepared. The Stoics have a practice of reflecting on all the things that could go wrong each day. We call this premeditatio malorum. premeditating the bad. Think of it as foresight. Before something happens, you ask, what could go wrong? What obstacles could pop up for me? Where could I face difficulties? It's the exercise of imagining things that could go wrong or be taken away from us. It helps us prepare for life's inevitable setbacks. We don't always get what is rightfully ours, even if we've earned it. Not everything is as clean and straightforward as we think they may be. Psychologically, we must prepare ourselves for this to happen and be okay with it. Be free, inwardly free. As Seneca would say, the unexpected blows of fortune fall heaviest and most painfully. And this is why the wise person thinks about them in advance. Just think about it. Is it possible to prepare for or prevent something you're unaware of? No. So you must think out of the box, out of your comfort zone. Change perspectives and see how well prepared you will be for everything in your life. The wise person doesn't see this act of negative visualization as pessimistic, but simply as a feature of their self-confidence. They think to themselves, I'm ready to face anything that happens, and I'm also ready to do the work necessary now to ensure I don't waste energy on problems that could have been solved in advance. Thinking strategically, making time to meditate and foresee will save you a lot of time, energy, and money. If you want to have a great day today, think about all the ways it might go wrong. What obstacles could pop up? Where could you face difficulties? For example, to be at a very important meeting, you need to predict that something may happen along the way. Your car may break down. There may be an accident. You must always have a plan B. Be prepared for that. Think about how you'd handle it, all the things you would need to do in response. Small things can save your life. When you're prepared, when you've thought of yourself in the future and the obstacles you must face, It's a true sign that you love and respect yourself. Practice being calm in the face of how overwhelming it might seem. Project yourself into the future and see yourself as calm, confident, handling and managing a situation in a mature and responsible way. Consider yourself confident, courageous. These are aspects of yourself you want to put to practice, and keep reminding yourself that this is your true self, not the one who loses it. You are not that kind of person. You are a calm, stoic type of person. You respond in the right way, at the right time, for the right reason. Consider what steps you can take now in anticipation of the dreams and goals you have set forth for yourself. Expect to have a successful and pleasant day, of course. Just be ready in case it isn't. Besides making contingency plans for these difficulties that may arise, this way of thinking can make you more grateful for the things you have in life, especially since you know how by the end of the day you might not have any of them anymore. Through a slight change of fortune, you could lose it all. And that is why, when you close each day, remember to be grateful for all the blessings. Think about how this message can help you to see things differently in your own life right now. How it can offer a solution. How it can help you to become more courageous in your life. Allow the message to enlighten you, to liberate you. Now is a good time to repeat your deep affirmation 3 times. No matter what may happen in your life, this deep affirmation, this decision you have taken, will definitely become a reality, something that you will experience. So choose it carefully. On the count of three, you will be returning to full open awareness. One, take a deep breath, expanding your shoulders, rising your hands over your head, and stretching like you do early in the morning. Two, take another deep breath and stretch your body from side to side, inhaling deeply and feeling revitalized, coming back to the awareness. Three, stretch your whole body from the tips of your fingers to the tips of your toes. You're expanding and awakening. You're feeling confident and powerful and much more certain of yourself. This is a good time to open your eyes if you've had them closed up until now. The reality may look the same, but you have changed. And that makes all the difference. Once again, thank you for supporting my work on Patreon.com.